I'm Shraddha, and welcome to Hindu Mythology World. In our previous video, Duryodhana's Boon Part 1, we saw how Arjun released Duryodhana from Gandharvas and how Duryodhana gives Arjuna a boon. Today, in this video, we are going to know what happened next. So, let's begin. Years passed and the battle of Kurukshetra began. It was too tough to fight for Pandavas because Bhishma, Karna, Dronacharya, who are great warriors, but all of them were in Kaurava's side. But the seventh day of war, Pandavas win. This makes Duryodhana angry. At the night, Duryodhana comes to Pitamah Bhishma. He arrogantly said to Bhishma, "You are not keeping up your promise and duties. Your favorites are in the opposite side. This is the reason we lost today because of you." Bhishma gets angry and said, "Don't ever doubt my duties towards Hastinapur or to the Kaurav family." Then Bhishma took the golden 5 arrows that was beside him. He chanted some hymns on the arrows and he said, "These are golden arrows. This celestial weapon. Using this, I can kill or slay anyone and whoever I wish, no matter how strong or skilled they are." Bhishma held the arrows in Duryodhana's hand. "Fantastic! It means the end of Pandavas. Tomorrow, I will give these arrows to you. And you know what you have to do." Saying so, Duryodhana left Bhishma's tent. But Krishna came to know this whole thing. He make a plan to save Pandavas. Krishna goes to Arjuna and said, "Arjuna, you need to go to the Kaurava's camp right now." Actually, to Duryodhana's in particular. "I have something that only you can do," Krishna said. Arjuna was shocked. He said, "Krishna, what are you talking about? You need me to go to Duryodhana's camp? I don't understand. Even if it's a message to convey, why should I go now? Moreover, if I go now, he might think that I have come to surrender." Arjuna spoke without knowing Krishna's plan. In the meantime, Yudhishthira too came to Krishna's camp. Knowing that Arjuna was called by Krishna on an urgent matter, Krishna explained the whole conversation between Duryodhana and Pitamaha to Yudhishthira. Hearing Krishna's words, Yudhishthira get frightened and said, "O Arjuna, Pitamaha has vowed to kill us. If he does that, definitely we will lose in the war tomorrow. We all know the skill and talent of Pitamaha." "Calm down, Yudhishthira. You are fighting for Dharma. Dharma always succeeds," Krishna said. Then Krishna turned towards Arjuna and spoke, "Arjuna, do you remember at the time of your exile, you saved Duryodhana from King of Gandharvas? Duryodhana assured you of a boon. This is the right time. Go to Duryodhana and ask for the celestial weapon of Pitamaha as a boon. He can't deny it. Don't delay. Act immediately before it reaches to others' hand." So Arjuna went to Duryodhana's camp. Hearing that Arjuna has come to see Duryodhana, Duryodhana was excited and said, "What happened, Arjuna? This skilled archer? What brings you here? Have you come to surrender?" "Yudhishthira should be doing it in person. Even if your brother Yudhishthira is not here, I will accept your surrender on behalf of him. I'm not that bad, you know it," Duryodhana mocked Arjuna. Arjuna controlled his anger and said, "As a Kshatriya, we are not afraid to die. I'm here to ask for a boon from you. The one you told as a favor for saving you from Chitrasen, king of Gandharvas. I would like to have the celestial astra of Pitama Bhishma, which you have. The one he wove to use it tomorrow to kill us. I don't want anything else as a favor or even as an auxiliary." Left without any option, Duryodhana gave the celestial weapon to Arjuna. After receiving that weapon, Arjuna returned to his camp and gave the weapon to Krishna. Krishna decided to destroy it so that no one can use it. Then all Pandavas sleep peacefully.